Mr. President, if you study the recent course of American history, you can note that there has been the emergence of opportunity and debates on freedom many times during the last 50 years. I think back to my time, my early years of education in high school and college, when America was in the midst of a debate about the rights of African Americans, the so-called civil rights movements of the 1960s. We've also had debates as well on the question of liberty and freedom from discrimination for women in America, for those who are disabled. It really is a hallmark of this democracy that we continue to expand opportunity and continue to question our own beliefs when it comes to the freedom which each of us cherishes. We are now in the midst of an interesting transformation in this country on the issue of the rights of people with different sexual orientation. We have seen some dramatic changes in just the last few years as we find more and more people speaking out against discrimination against those of a different sexual orientation. And, of course, the landmark decision in Obergefell, where the U.S. Supreme Court recognized the right for same-gender, same-sex marriage. This is not without controversy and not without dissenters. But the mainstream of America, the vast majority of Americans, believe that we are moving along the same path that we did when we talked about the rights of those who were minorities, women, and the disabled, when we say that people should be free of discrimination because of their own sexual orientation. That's why it strikes me as unusual, more than coincidental, that in June, the LGBTQ Pride Month, our Republican colleagues would decide to bring to the floor the nomination of a Texas District Court nominee, Matthew Kaczmarczyk, who has repeatedly written in his personal capacity about his opposition to LGBTQ rights and the Obergefell decision. Mr. Kaczmarczyk's nomination was reported out of the Senate Judiciary Committee on a party line vote in February, but for some reason, the Republican leadership decided to wait and force a vote on the floor of the Senate during Pride Month. Now they're calling for a vote this week. Mr. Kaczmarczyk has not been shy about his hostility to marriage equality and transgender Americans. On June 24, 2015, he wrote an article in which he noted that the Supreme Court would decide the Obergefell case in the next few weeks, and he speculated whether five justices would, quote, in his words, invent a constitutional right to same-sex marriage. After the decision, Mr. Kaczmarczyk wrote a disparaging summary, which I won't quote into the record, but certainly shows his opposition to the fundamental premise behind that decision. He did it again in the Liberty Institute blog of October 16, 2014. He signed a letter in 2016 relating to transgender Americans, calling them a delusion, quote unquote. Last December, the parents of 300 transgender children, including 39 from my state of Illinois, wrote the Senate in opposition to Mr. Kaczmarczyk's nomination and said, quote, our children are not a delusion, and neither is our love and support for them, end of quote. Even though Mr. Kaczmarczyk has expressed strident personal views opposing LGBTQ rights, and even though he's litigated frequently in cases involving these matters, he would not commit to recuse himself from cases involving this issue were he to be confirmed by the Senate. I oppose the Kaczmarczyk nomination. This is yet another extreme nominee outside the mainstream of American thinking who does not deserve to be rubber stamped for a lifetime appointment by the United States Senate.